So, have you recently got yourself a brand new shiny iPad, like this 9th generation 2021 iPad, and you want to get to this main home screen that you can see here? Well, today I'm going to show you a guide on how to set up your iPad for the first time. So that's right guys, you've probably seen this screen before on an iPad and you're probably wondering how on earth do I get to it and how do I set up my iPad to this stage? Well, I'm going to show you how to do that. The first way I'm going to show you is by using another device, another Apple device, and how you can move your data over to your new iPad. This can be an iPhone or another iPad. And the other way I'm going to show you is if you were setting up a brand new iPad and you weren't moving over your data at all. Now, one thing I must just add in here, if you're brand new to the Apple ecosystem, as it were, and you've never had an Apple device before, then you must set yourself up with a brand new account. And the best way to do this is to go on Apple's website and set yourself up a brand new account and follow the instructions there. Once you've completed the setup online, best thing to do is come back to this video and then I'll show you how to set up your iPad. Well, without further ado, let's begin. So first of all, make sure you have your other Apple device handy. And then after this, what we want to do is just sort of open up the screen here. And then we want to choose the language we want everything displayed in. So I'm setting English. And then the country that you're from. So I'm from the United Kingdom. So it's setting the language for this. So next of all, with our other device, so I've got my iPhone. What you want to do is hold it close to the actual iPad. And you should get something on your device to say, set up your new iPad. So I'm going to click connect. And we're going to start it here. Now what you need to use is your camera on your other device. I'm going to sort of navigate my way here to these blue dots. You can't really see it, but it'll get it. And there we go. It's setting up. But first of all, I need to verify the same code that I have on my iPhone. So I'm just going to put this in. And now the transfer will start. So as you can see here, it says setting up your iPad. And what you want to do is just keep your other device nearby. So it's just going to activate my iPad now. And this might take a minute or two. So we'll just wait for this to happen. And then after this, what we want to do is we'll need to set up Touch ID on this actual iPad. So I'm going to click continue and I'm just going to get my thumb ready. You can use anything you want and just keep repeating touching until it gets your full print. Now, once it's got your full print, it'll ask you to adjust your grip. So just twist your thumb or finger a little bit more around to get a bit more of a bigger print. And then once that's done, we click complete and then it's going to continue on setting up the iPad. The next step is some terms and conditions going to come along. You can read these if you want to. There's not many. I'm going to click agree. And then it's going to continue on a bit more. And this stage might take a few seconds. Or it might take a couple of minutes. But either way, you'll get there. Once this is completed, you will next of all get the option to retrieve a backup. So as you can see here, it's saying it's found a backup of mine. And if I click here, you can see it's got my old iPad Pro one here. And I'm happy with that to get that backup. And then after this, if you want to, you can just double check your settings like Siri and everything and then just press continue afterwards. And this might take another second or two to load. But next of all, it's to put in a card if you want to do that. So I'm just going to set up my Apple Pay and quickly add a card here. And next, set up Siri. And I'm going to say I'm going to continue on to have Siri on my iPad. And then next of all is some just information if you want to share it with Apple. So it's up to you if you want to share or not. Very self-explanatory. And then my iCloud restore for my backup is going to begin. Now, what you don't need to have anymore is that other device. So when you had like my iPhone here, you can just take this away now. You don't need it anymore. You can just leave your iPad restore from its backup. So I'm just going to click done here and I'm going to leave this be. And then it's going to restart in a moment. And then hopefully after all of that, all my data should be back on this iPad. And here we are, we're nearing the end of the reboot of after all my data's been put back on this iPad. So I'm just going to give it another second or two. And then we're going to get to the lock screen. Now I'm just going to put my code in. And then after this, we can see we're on the main page of the iPad. Now everything around here is saying waiting, as you can see. And depending on how fast your internet speed is also how long it will take to restore all these apps onto your iPad. But once they're fully downloaded, your iPad is ready to go. So as you can see so far, this iPad is absolutely amazing. But something else what is truly amazing is to do with this channel. This channel recently got over 230,000 subscribers. So I've decided to do a giveaway for when we get over 260,000 subscribers. And that giveaway is for this. It's for a brand new iPad Pro. So you might as well have just got yourself a brand new iPad, but how would you like to get yourself an iPad Pro? Well, it's quite simple how you can get your hands on this model. All I want to know from you guys in the comments below is what Apple gear are you planning to buy in 2021? Maybe you bought yourself this iPad that you've got right here, the 2029 ninth generation, or maybe you're going to be buying yourself a brand new iPhone or something else. Let me know in the comments below. And when we get over 260,000 subscribers, and that's not that far away from now, I'm going to be giving away this iPad Pro. The specs of this iPad Pro, it is a 12.9 inch model, and it also has 8 GB of RAM and 256 GB of storage. Also, after that you've basically written your comment below, make sure you subscribe to this channel at the same time and hit that notification bell. Because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, you'll want to get that notification to find out if you've been the lucky person to get your hands on this iPad Pro. Also at the same time as well, guys, if you're feeling generous and if you're enjoying this video so far, please also do press the like button. Well, let's continue on with the video. So this time I'm going to show you how to set up an iPad if you didn't have an Apple device already and you've made an account like we talked about at the beginning. So select your languages and also which country you're from. And then after this, we want to click setup manually this time. We want to connect to our Wi-Fi. So I'm going to put my Wi-Fi password in here. So after putting your code in, you'll have to give it a second or two, or maybe up to a minute for your iPad to register onto your Wi-Fi. And then after this, the activation setup will start. This again may take up to a minute, but then we just want to accept these terms and conditions. Just click continue for data and privacy. And then we want to set up Touch ID. So same again, just put your thumb on and just keep pressing it and dabbing it down until it's got a full print of your thumb or your finger. And then after this, it will probably tell you to adjust your grip, as you can see here. We click continue and then we just adjust our grip a little bit. And as you can see, it's grabbing my thumb a little bit more. After this, we press continue and we can set up a passcode or a password of your choice. So I'm just going to do this quickly. And then on the next page, what we're going to say is that we don't actually have another device to restore our data from. If we did, we can select any of these options. But because we don't have another Apple device for this type of setup, we're just going to press on the bottom tab, what is called Don't Transfer Apps and Data. We then on the next page need to put in our Apple ID and our password that we set up on the Apple website. So I'm just going to put this in and we're going to click next. And then we're just going to accept the terms and conditions. And then the iPad will take a little longer then to activate. And then after this, we should be able to set up a couple more settings on the next page. And then we can just make this as our own iPad and then press continue. You can set up Apple Pay if you want to. And then next we can set up Siri by pressing on the continue button. And then we can basically accept all the terms and conditions behind all the things of sharing our information with Apple. And then we can click get started. Once this happens, what will happen is that we will get lots of messages and notification to use certain sensors and bits and pieces inside the iPad. But as you can see, we're on the main home page for a brand new iPad. So I'm just swiping here. You can see all the default apps are installed. But as you can see, the news app isn't working fully. So I'm just going to open that and let it load. And then once it's loaded up, I'm just going to click allow while using this app. Or there we go. And then I've got all my news. If I close this back down again, there we go. My news is now fully working. But as you can see, that is your new iPad fully set up. So as you can see, it is dead easy to get onto this page by using either of those methods. And now you can have all the fun of being an iPad user with your brand new shiny iPad. Well guys, I hope this video has been really informative. And if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. Also at the same time as well, if you want the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please also hit that subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys. I'll see you really soon. Bye.